Hello, darlings, and welcome to the Nameless Show by Vuyo Joboda. Remember that we are still running that name competition, so please go onto social media and comment on the name that you think we should give this Nameless Show. But out of all of that, I hope that you're having a beautiful Sunday evening, and thank you so much for joining us here on the show. Today on the show, we do have gold winners, we do have gold medalists, we do have royalty in the dance industry. I'm talking about Ricardo Koopman and Leane Phiri, who are from the Ricardo Dance School. Hello, darling.
Hi.
Hello.
How are you doing?
We're good. Good, and you?
I'm very well, and I know that our viewers at home are also excited
yeah.
to know about all this gold medalist that I'm talking about. let's start with you, Ricardo. You are a phenomenon. And you've been dancing for the past 25 years now, or teaching dancing for the past 25 years. Share with us on your journey in the dancing world.
Yeah, I started dance when I was the age of 5.
Yeah.
And I'm from Hout Bay, fishing village. My father wasn't really very keen completely that I started this journey, because he clearly wanted me to become one of the fishermen and be one of those tough, strong fishermen. But I joined this through a drama school, firstly, by the lady called Pippa Duffy. And she took us on this incredible journey. We could not really speak English, but we've learned how to speak English through dance. And I think it's a journey that everybody should actually engage with. I've done this now, I mean, I've been teaching for about 30 years, to just correct you on
yes.
But the journey of teaching, it's the most incredible, incredible feeling to just give and share with others. You know, whether you are pink, orange, or have the money or not, everybody should be dancing. I believe I used to walk from Hout Bay to town to get my trainings. Tough feet though, even that my dad wanted me to be in those gumboots. I decided that dancing was going to be my thing. And you know, I've just been very blessed, and it is a gift that I've given from God, and I'm sharing this gift with everybody, that the doors are open for everybody to come in and join the Ricardo's Modern Dance Studio.
Yes, and so from the age of 5, fast forward to the year where you decide to begin this incredible school called the
Ricardo's Modern Dance Studio.
Yes, and you joined the studio, Leane. When did you join? When did you join the studio?
I joined the studio in 2015. Yeah, I remember I was at school, and I never took dance seriously. It was just like something I did like for fun. I didn't know it could be something I could take as serious as I'm doing, as I'm taking it now. And Ricardo helped me with that, because when I grew up, everyone danced. Like, it wasn't something, I didn't know it was something that could be special or like a gift. And like dancing with Ricardo helped me like realize that.
And you're from Zimbabwe.
Yeah, I'm from Zim.
Yeah, and do you think that the dance industry is different here than it is in Zim? And did you know back in Zim that you wanted to be a dancer?
Honestly, no, I didn't. Like, when I came here to South Africa, that's when I realized like, oh, there's actually a lot more to be like discovered. And when I was in Zim, just like I said, like everyone danced, you know, you could be known for that girl that dances so nice, but like it wasn't more, like it was just that and nothing more. And now, like when I look in Zim, like they are actually evolving, like from the last time when I was there, like they are taking it a bit more serious than it was before. I think that's it.
And Ricardo, you know, this dance school has helped change the lives of so many young people, and Leane is evidence of that. Why for you do you think it's important to have such initiatives for young people in and around, you know, the world, for them to kind of help develop and to become bright young minds like Leane is here?
As I said, you know, dance is quite a powerful tool, and everybody should be hanging on to this tool, because, you don't have to really become necessarily a dancer, but it empowers you in so many ways. With your academics, you can become coordinated, yeah. you can even become, when you become a doctor or whatever, you know how to work about the anatomy of the body, how things work. But however, it's a very special and a very incredible form of art. It requires so much discipline, so much dedication. You know, you just have to be an absolute, like I would say the little ones would be little fairies, and they have to come up in their little tippy toes. Now when I would look at Leane, how she's achieved, and the Aesthetic, the competitions that she's done really very well. And for me also, it's not just about the what you achieve with the gold medals, but the journey that they actually know where they started and how they've progressed. Yes. And this can just feed feed everybody, and everybody should be dancing. Dance actually saved my life in the old South Africa. And it's a very powerful tool, and I'm hanging on to it for the rest of my life.
Oh, wow.
And everybody should be dancing.
Yeah. Everybody should be. I mean, dancing is a liberating feeling, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
When you dance, you feel liberated, you feel free, you feel happy. Yeah. And I know that you mentioned that there was some gold there somewhere that someone took home. What was this for, and when did this happen?
So I had the Cape Town, they have this Cape Town Aesthetic, so it's like a dance competition every year. And I remember I entered for the first time with Ricardo, and I was so nervous because, like, this is my first time ever performing on stage for, like, actual judges and stuff. And I remember I had, I got an honors, so that's, like, after the gold. And I was quite disappointed, you know, like, you know that feeling, oh, I wish I did better. But then I didn't give up, I just kept on working on myself. And then in 2016, I remember I danced my second dance, and then I got, I got diploma. So I'm like, what is a diploma? I've never won a diploma. And Ricardo's like, you got a diploma, Leane. I'm like, I don't know what that is. It's like, oh, it means you got gold, like, for your dance. Mm. And I was so happy. And like, ever since that day, I've just kept on working on myself and not giving up. Like, if I'd like given up on the first performance, then I might have not actually gotten, you know, the gold. And I've also gotten some gold from the exams that we did with the, Ricardo. And yeah.
Yeah.
That's really cool.
Oh, yeah, man. Saying that, just to add on to that story, it's a, as I said, it's not about how, if you're going to achieve the gold medal or that. But if you perfect yourself in the dance environment, in the studio, the proof is in the pudding. You will achieve, whether it's the gold diploma or the honors, it's still that incredible feeling that I've danced from the heart, and everything is just beautiful. And I think often we all want to get a double A, but we're not all equipped maybe in that field. Mm. But if you strive to work towards what your field is, or you can achieve so many other factors in your life. Yeah. You know, it doesn't have to, you don't all have to become doctors or lawyers, or that is absolutely cool to become a dancer.
Yeah.
And it's a hard profession.
Mm. And we're gonna get to see the proof in the pudding later on in the show today. So you wanna stay tuned to see her dance. And Ricardo, what can one expect? Like, what kind of dancing can one expect from the Ricardo Modern Dance School? That we're going to be seeing later on in the show when she does dance, but just give us a picture of what we can expect from this.
Yeah, school. What I teach is, I teach modern, and then the contemporary, and then also the hip-hop, and then creative movement, and then also the latest moves. Now today, I think Leane is probably going to show a little bit of the contemporary. I don't know if she wants to swing in some of the hip-hop moves as well, but we will leave that up to her, you know.
Okay, and Leane, what is the one lesson that you've taken from, before we go to ad break, the one lesson that you've taken from the dance school?
From the dance school? Oh, it has helped me a lot. The one thing is just believe in yourself. And you cannot get anywhere without hard work. You cannot just expect like, okay, I want this and just expect to get it. You have to actually work for it. And yeah, just believe in yourself and it will happen.
Oh man, it definitely will happen. And what's gonna happen later on after the break is we're gonna be seeing Leane on the dance floor showing us those contemporary moves from the Ricardo Modern Dance School. So all you have to do is just stay tuned, sit back, relax, and we'll see you straight after this. And welcome back, darlings. I hope that you're still enjoying the show. Please do go on social media. We're at Bricks TV and share with us on your thoughts about what you think about the show today. We're talking all things dance, all things contemporary, all things music, all things winning. We're joined by Leane Phiri and Ricardo Koopman. Guys, thank you so much for joining us once again.
Thank you.
I hope that you're also having a good time on the show today.
Awesome.
You are? Ricardo, you've traveled the world. Through dance. Do you want to share with us some of the exciting moments that you've come across, whether it be South Africa or anywhere else that you've traveled through dance?
In Switzerland, my first time going to Switzerland is absolutely very prim and proper. There's absolutely, the cleanliness is just impeccable. It's just fantastic. There was a dance school that I walked into and I saw these people dancing. And I started to look at them and say, oh, but why is your hair like loose? Why is it like that? And I walked up to them and not knowing it is not my classmate, I just walked right up to typical teachers and I engaged and I said, no, move your hair out. And from this day onwards, the teacher actually said, who are you? And I said, I'm from South Africa. And so welcome. And I started to teach there then. Every year I'm on their board. I work with them with the competitions every year. So I'm really very blessed with this incredible opportunity that's been granted to me. The styles of dancing, it's very different. Here they're very more in the showbiz. They also do a lot of hip hop, but it's very focused and let's bring it on. But the one thing I've learned there, it's the absolute discipline that they have, the absolute discipline. The hair that was loose was not the first priority, but the discipline when they come into that class, they will not say a word to their teacher or whoever's taking the class. The respect and they're just unbelievable. I've experienced that.
Yeah.
Yeah, saying that this was a very incredible journey for me to be part of the Swiss dance.
Yeah.
And thank you to Tanya for that.
Tanya, thank you. And what is the best, what is the one style that you think across the world, this one takes the round of applause? This dance style, if I want someone doing it, that I think that is what dance is.
Well, this is quite difficult because I'm completely, I teach the hip hop, but I think the contemporary demands so much more strength, so much more work.
Yes.
The technique needs to be spot on. You can't just come in and say, okay, I'm just going to do a swag and there we go. It's the hip hop also have got their own techniques, but I think definitely the contemporary for me, I'll give it 10.
All right. And for you, what's your favorite dance style?
I would say the same. Contemporary, like, it is very, like, it's not about one thing. You can make it whatever you want it to be, either sad, happy. I feel like you can express yourself, and it takes a lot of work. You need to practice every day, you need to stretch, you need to point. So I feel like contemporary is like the best.
The one that makes you feel like, now I'm dancing, you know? And for you, I mean, we spoke about how Ricardo has traveled the world and some of the achievements that he's had.
Yeah.
What for you would you say, if I want to achieve this as a dancer, this is what I'd like to get into, this is what I'd like to achieve?
I would actually want to start my own dance
competition.
Studio. Coming for you. Like, dancing with Ricardo has given me so much, like, so many opportunities. Like, for example, I performed at the Baxter Theatre and Artscape, which I never thought I would. So like just being in the theater business and like being around that, that's what I want. I can't really say for sure like exactly what I want because I'm like only 16, but that's the idea of what I would like to involve myself in.
Yeah, you mentioned that you're only 16, and I'm wondering, how does your family really support this as something that can be a career, or is it just seen as like a hobby?
Well, at first, my mom was a bit like off board with it, but then she is a very supportive person, so she came to that like conclusion, like, okay, this is what you really want to do. Let's finish school. If you want to go to a dance school after that, we got you. I can help you just as long as you like focus on school now and not like play games. My dad has also been there for me. He's always telling me you can do anything you want to. It doesn't matter what it is as long as you put your mind to it.
Yeah.
So I've had the support I needed from both like my parents. So
yeah.
I feel like they would let me take it further than it
as a
career.
And Ricardo, you've worked with a lot of students, you've worked with a lot of parents. What do you think has been some of the building blocks to young people becoming successful dancers, from being young to then taking it as a career? What are some of the things? Is it family support that makes them become successful dancers? Is it discipline? You know, what are some of those key values and principles and that you teach them, but also that they need from externally?
I definitely think it is the support from the parents. This plays a major role in the kids' lives. But saying that, the discipline and the actual focus, if you want to do something, go out and do it. And you don't have to be completely 100% perfect in whatever you're doing. Like if you want to do a pirouette, and I say do one pirouette, you would find somebody, so, but I saw on TV they do two, so they just go two all round. And I encourage that kind of, motivate them to actually do their own research and see where they want to become. And it's not just about that dance, maybe just that inner feeling. I come from, as I said, my father was a fisherman, and I was absolutely loved by him, but he just could not understand the soft shoes on my feet all the time. But eventually he had no other choice but say, I'll support you, and because you are so driven by this. And also like in Thailand, when we were with the tsunami, we were actually in the tsunami and we survived it.
Yeah.
But we went back the following year and I had nothing to give. I had no finance, but I had the gift that God gave me to teach. So I went into the orphanage homes to the survivors there, and I've been teaching there the dance to actually just empower them. And it's an international language.
Yes.
And I feel like, sorry, just adding to that, like, if you want to be successful, like, and want support, you have to show them how much you actually
want it. Yeah.
You can't just expect them, like, growing up, obviously, no mom doesn't want their like kid to be a doctor, you know. And when you find something different than the traditional, you need to show them like the amount of work you're putting into it, and eventually they'll get it.
Yeah.
No matter how long it takes.
And dancing is such a beautiful art form. I think,
yeah.
you know, when the parents then watch the kids, they see and they feel that my child is laying out their heart on that on that stage. So it is the year 2019, and I'd like to give you guys put you on the spot here. What is the dance move that we should be dancing to this December? Do you think that one where you're like, okay, you see this one at home, this is the one that you should take home with you and get yourselves ready for with
the shoot? No, I would say the whoa.
Oh, this one,
the whoa. Yeah,
okay. And how to do that? Let's do a quick
it depends.
Tutorial
it depends on the attitude.
Yeah,
so you're like out there, like, I got this.
Yeah.
And you just throw it.
What? So we're throwing like a ball.
Yeah. You just throw it. Uh-huh. And you just pick
catch
it up.
It.
Yeah, catch yeah. it. Uh-huh. Just like throw it, I got it.
You know what I mean? All right. So yeah. Are these kind of dance moves, do you regard that as dance? Things like the nene and
yes.
Is that still part of traditional dancing?
Yes, we still use them. We've got the names. Obviously, it's a lot of names.
Yes.
For these specific moves that we named them. And within the hip hop, there is incredible names that just pops up.
Yeah.
And the next, like the twerk and the all this. And then sometimes when you get a 4-year-old kid come and showing these things, it's just 1 second.
Yeah.
But they are so advanced with us, I suppose, with the social media and things
yes.
that is out there.
All right. Yeah, Thank you, guys.
Yeah, my wish was to actually to go and teach in Zimbabwe.
Okay.
And I motivated this for the kids in Zimbabwe to at the schools to
yes.
actually get themselves together, get all together. Yeah. You've got 3 months, get two rand, like we would say,
yeah.
$2 together, and a teacher will come out and give you something that you can look forward to.
Mm, mm.
And it didn't really work this time, but
yeah.
hopefully it will. There will be somebody that will organize that sometime.
Definitely,
yeah.
definitely
awesome.
Happening very, very much soon. Guys, thank you so much for joining us on the show.
Thank you.
And all the best with everything that you're going to be doing in the dance industry. We can't wait to see you flying that SA and the Zimbabwean African flag high
yeah.
all across the world. And thank you for imparting knowledge, skill to young people across the world. And I think we should vote
out.
Right. So I'm a vote out, and I'd like to thank you at home for joining us on the show, on the Nameless Show here with Vuyo Joboda. Next week, I promise you, we will have a name for the show voted and given by you. I love you so much, and I hope to see you same place, same time here on Bricks TV. And I am Vuyo Joboda, darlings. But now it's cheers, or maybe it's
whoa. Stone cold, you see me standing, but I'm dying on the floor.